Okay, somebody is leaving, you have to do the full and final settlement. That is one. When someone joins, okay, the payroll has been processed or his personal details did not come in, payroll missed it. So you may do a quick pay. Somebody going on leave, he needs the amount urgently. Somebody not well, he needs the amount urgently. So you can do a quick pay. Okay?
Yeah, just proceed.
Now, after you do the quick pay, the amount is processed, how much is to be paid, then we run a process called as prepayment. Prepayment will look at the employee's banking information and allocate the payment instructions accordingly for respective banks. How much to pay by check, how much to pay to which bank, which amount, how much percentage. You remember we had put it on the payment method?
Yeah. Oh, actually, I think we did not see to define the account.
We saw. No. I'll show you one more time. We must have forgotten.
Yeah. No, I do. I remember that we never did. I don't think we defined account course.
I'll show you. So that is the prepayment process. And after that, nowadays what happens, earlier they used to print checks. Nowadays, hardly any company prints checks, salary checks. They will generate the bank payment file, the electronic fund transfer file, and send it to the bank. Okay. After that, the next step is the costing process. Costing process is where the debit credit entries get generated. And the final process is transfer to GL.
This we see that day, right? This process.
No, we haven't seen. We'll see this. Okay. So the in between, at any point of time, any of these processes can fail. There might be an error. There might be an issue. So you can do a rollback. So rollback process is used to undo whatever you have processed as if it never happened. Okay.
Yeah.
Remember this sequence. This sequence they may ask you during interview also. Okay. Now, there is just one more process. Let me just add it here. Usually after this, we run archive payroll process. This is like it is. It keeps a copy of the entire payroll, makes a copy from which you can generate the EFT payments and all those stuff.
What is this archive? Is it mandatory?
Archive. So archive is basically the method which is also used for generating pay slips.
Okay. Basically, okay, now this step calculate payroll means you will submit some program, calculate the payroll.
Correct.
These are programs, right? You will.
Yes. These are programs in Fusion. They are calling it flows.
Flows, but at the time of payroll, what will happen? Calculating payroll, what will happen?
The calculation. So each and every employee who belongs to that particular payroll, when you submit a payroll, you submit it by individual payrolls. So monthly payroll, weekly payroll, bi-weekly payroll. So when you submit that payroll, all employees who belong to that particular payroll are processed one by one.
So it will generate the final, sir, final net payment.
Correct. Correct.
Okay, fine. Now the prepayment.
Prepayment will calculate based on the payment methods, what amount and what particular bank will receive how much amount.
No, I don't understand. Can you explain the example?
So suppose you have said your bank of account is, let's say, Abu Dhabi Bank.
Okay.
So Abu Dhabi Bank, this much, this is your account number. And the prepayment process will pick up Abu Dhabi Bank account number and give the net amount that has to be credited.
Basically, you can tell us the payment process.
Prepayment process will do that.
No, I don't understand the term prepayment. Basically, the payroll you processed. The amount will go to bank for telegraphic transfer. Why they call this prepayment? That's why I'm confused.
Because you are not making the payment yet. You are making the payment through either the check or through the bank's transfer.
So you are initiating the transfer.
Yes. You are doing this process is just before actual physical payment. Once you do that check payment or you do the electronic fund transfer, that is where you are doing the actual payment.
So basically, this I can say they just generated payment, check. Correct. Or transfer.
Correct.
Or transfer.
So these are terms that, you know, actually people in US, America, they use it. So that's how these terms have become popular within Oracle and Fusion.
So the actual payroll.
Sorry?
What about the archive payroll?
Archive payroll is basically a process which creates, you can say it like it creates a copy of the actual payroll run, which is used for generating pay slips, generating the bank statements, which account has to be paid, how much, all those things are done using the archive payroll process.
We see this process, right, when you run.
Sorry?
So, can you show the process, right?
Yes, I'll show you. Just wait. This is the flow. Okay. Now, you can run these individual processes one by one, or there is in case of you, just like in case of US, like I told you, these are called flows. In the US, there is one flow, which is called US Simplified Payroll, where if you submit the process, 17 different reports and processes will be submitted one by one. It is like a request set. You remember in EBS, we had a request set where you can have combination of reports and processes.
Yeah, that I know.
So like that, flow is also can be a combination of reports and processes. So this flow is a combination of 17 different reports and processes.
So this is by US, the UAE. So every legislation have the program like this, right?
Correct.
But mostly how they run?
Mostly they run it one by one. Only when you know for 100% sure that nothing is going wrong, you will run that big flow. Because if something goes wrong, you have to go back and roll back. Okay.
Yeah.
I'll come to costing later. Let us first look at the. Do you have the URL with you in right in front of you?
Yeah. Just a minute.
Thank you.
Yeah, this was I sent received last.
You have it?
Yeah, I said I told you in chat now.
Okay.
Pratheer, Saurabh, can you send me some sample CV or your CV to update my? Some effective to show as a functional consultant.
Check on the net. You will get it on the net. A lot of people have shared it.
Shared, but just confused. If you have some anything, just for reference.
Okay.
And till now, I you didn't show me that. I could not find their old sessions in Google Drive, which is shared.
I'll show you today.
Whatever you sent in email, the two or three, it is there.
Okay. Now, from client groups, we go to payroll.
Did we talk about payroll periods, right?
Yeah. When we define the payroll, we saw the period in a cutoff date.
Yeah.
2 days, okay. 1 days. Okay. Now, if you scroll down, you will find this flow submission and results. So there is one quick pay payments. There is one simplified quick pay.
This is from my client groups, right?
My client groups payroll. So if you go to simplified quick pay, you can search for any person. Let's say Carol Perry. So, see, this is the name of the payroll she belongs to. Payroll name, semi-monthly. This is the current period. This is the regular salary. These are the different elements that she has assigned. If you want to make more element entries, you have to go to element entries. You remember that screen we went to where we saw the salary? You can go there and add more element entries.
Can we create one? Okay, fine. I'll create an employee to create.
You'll do that. You try out all the different ways, you know, create an employee, create element, assign that element to the employee. That way, this date earned, this payroll is important. If this payroll is not assigned, you will not be able to process the employee. Remember that. Huh?
Because you're doing assignment, we have to apply, right?
Payroll action, relationship. Now, over here, you have this submit button. Once you have, this is just for review. Okay. Once you have reviewed it, submit it. So this is where your fast formulas get kicked off. So the Oracle payroll fast formulas.
Now, can you show me this element entry and the fast formula for this employee?
Yeah, if there is anything, we'll see that. Let it run, then I'll show you.
So basic salary coming from salary basis for other element, they will feed in the element entry screen.
Correct. Correct.
So unless if there is any fast formula, fast formula. Uh-huh.
It takes some time. So when this tick comes, it means it's processed. So we click on actions.
So how do you send the payslip to employee by email?
Email, or you can, they can see it through self-service also.
So how to do that? So we are seeing self-service.
Yeah, so those archive process that you're doing, na, it takes care of that and it automatically publishes. There is a standard feature within the application where employees can go and see.
So you cannot send it to email?
You can send it, but you don't need to. Na. The application is showing it to you. Why do you need to send it separately?
Okay, so they can...
You have to create a BI publisher report and have it sent. You have to do all of that.
Now, once you process, employee only see through the self-service portal, right?
Correct.
But how do you configure that self-service portal?
That is, by default, it is configured for employees to view.
So there is no self-service concept here in UAE.
Yeah, there is no self-service concept. They call it me.
So because in EBS, they have a self-service. There are some setups they will do, I think.
Mm-hmm. No, no. In self-service also, the... SOE, there is a statement of earnings that you do, na? That one you can immediately see once it's generated.
No, if you want a proper payslip, we have to develop a program. It's Oracle is already having.
That is, the Oracle already has one.
If you want to customize a different format, if you want to put up my logo and all, and
you have to customize it. See, this is the statement of earnings, basically, which is like the pay slip. This is the net amount. This is the total earnings, tax deduction, pre-tax deduction, employer distribution contributions. And this is like the summary. If you want to see the details, click on show details here. And the individual breakups will be visible.
Just is showing, it doesn't look like a payslip, right? It's just showing a statement. It's a statement.
That's why they call it statement of earnings. So this is like gross, and the individual breakups here, you can see at the bottom, earnings is this much, regular salary this much, bonus is this much. This calculate year to date. This is the balance, which is the running total. How much he has been paid till date against that particular element. Employee tax deductions.
How do you see as an employee?
you first watch what I am saying, what I am showing you.
Yeah.
Then you will miss out what I am showing you. Later on, you will think it's not shown.
Okay.
Now, if you go up, you see the pre-tax deductions. These are the individual breakups. So if you expand this, you will see the details inside this. This is the element that has been processed. Against that,
all this is coming here. Elements. There are so many elements for this employee.
Yeah. So they are linked to the classification.
No, can you go up a little bit, please, from starting?
Okay, so one by one, you can see all the elements, all the details over here.
No, what it is showing balance name as is all element names.
No, those are not element names. The element names are inside it. If you click on this, this is the element name. If there is an element, then there will be an element name. This is amount is zero here, so there is no element. So if you click on this, see this is the element name. Okay, so this is like your payslip, the statement of earnings. Other than this, if you go back to actions, you have here run results. Okay, run results is like your individual elements that have been processed. Each and every element along with their input values. Okay. So these are the input values that will show up here. If you look at this particular one, let's say, where is regulars? Where is salary? See, regular salary earnings. So whatever input values, see, all these are the input values, which state, which county, which city, what percentage, what is the earnings, net amount is put into the pay value, final pay value that is there, that it will be put inside that. Okay.
So you show you what all the process ran for this.
Or no, not process, every element that has been processed. Elements that have been processed. And what is the individual input values? What is the final processed pay value? Okay. Here you can see all the different processes also by this particular employee, the past processes that have been done. And if you want to see anything else, again, click on actions.
How do you know some past formula is available for me?
You don't know. You have to go to that element and check where we had that, where we attached the status processing rule. Na? There you have to check which formula is attached.
So from here, we don't know whether any past formula is attached or not.
Correct. You can't make out. Usually, you can guess because you know what amount is being calculated. And if the same amount is not being passed in the pay value, that means there is some kind of calculation happening. So you can guess, but you can't be sure 100%. So under actions, we looked at the run results. These are the balances results. That means individual balances that you have for a particular person, you can look at all their balances. So you can search for individual balance names or you can search by balance groups. So you have the balance name here. So let's say one particular. And you have to search. Basically, it's a place for searching. So how much value, how much has been paid, what is the dimension? That means relationship run. For that particular run, this is the amount that has been paid.
No, actually, it balances. When I'm just confused. Actually, when you in EBS, something they do with balance setup or not, right?
Same here, thing here. Nothing in different.
Basically, what we see, we define the elements.
Hmm.
Right? In that, we define anything balance or something. I don't think.
No, when you balances, you define separately, and those balances you link to the elements.
But we didn't see balances, right? I just defined elements.
You haven't seen balances? Okay, no. I'll show you balances. So this is run results. Run results we have seen, statement of earnings we have seen, calculation cards. These are basically individual pieces. What Fusion is doing is they are breaking the entire calculation into smaller pieces. Like, you know, you can do a calculation card for, let's say, taxes. You can do a calculation card for, you know, state taxes, federal taxes, just to help you to process your payroll faster. So these are being called as, like, this is a tax withholding calculation card. That means how much tax will be withheld.
For any salary person, we need to define elements.
Correct.
Right? Correct. The element, is it element?
These are not elements. These calculation card is basically a small, you can say it is a slice of the payroll of an employee. So you are doing just a piece of that processing.
We are defining elements. Like that, we have to define then calculation card.
Calculate. If you want to. Otherwise, this is optional.
I will do this.
You may not define it also. You can just run directly all your payroll elements through the payroll process.
I don't understand calculation card. What is
don't worry about calculation card. Worry about elements and the other things. Now, this is messages. Messages is all the messages that have come through the quick pay. If you remember during your formulas, we had said you can pass out a message through the formula results. So those messages you can display here. So you can see all the messages, like, you know, balance is this much, or, you know, happy holidays, or your bonus for this month is this, sales bonus is this. Those kind of values you can pass as messages. And there are no attachments here. Otherwise, you can see attachments. So these are basically as far as your quick pay is concerned. Okay. Now, after your quick pay is done, the next step would be quick pay payments. So when you go to quick pay payments, you can again search for Carol Perry. So this is the, you can, this is like, already this is processed actually. So quick pay payments, what quick pay payments does is, it will submit the quick pay and it will also submit the both at the same time, the quick pay process and the prepayment. So first it will calculate quick pay, then it will do the prepayments. So they have combined these two processes together. See, first this quick pay is running, then the quick pay prepayments is running. So this is the quick pay. This is the statement of earnings. This is the quick pay prepayments. Okay. So one when you click on this actions, see, this is the payment details. Okay. Direct deposit. This is the amount. This is the bank. Bank of America, this is the bank account, and this is the amount that has to be paid. This is the net figure 1863.28 that you see here, net payment. This amount is to be paid through the direct deposit. Got it? Sadik?
Yeah, I'm here. I'm seeing it. I'm just checking each by each element.
So this is the net amount that you are paying to through the payment method. Okay. If you want to make an external, like you want to cut a check or you want to, then you have to change the payment method and then make the payment to the person. Understood?
Somehow I think I need to run.
Yeah, you will have to run this, step by step. You have to do multiple times, not just once. Payroll is not simple. This is good thing about QuickPay is you are processing one employee, so it is very fast. If you submit, like if I go to submit a flow, this is where you go for submitting different individual flows. Like let's say I want US legislative data group.
So you have to run by legislative wise.
Yes.
You can't run all at the same time.
No. See, this is the calculate payroll. This is the process. Okay. So when you are submitting a payroll for everybody, then this is calculate payroll. And you can give a flow name. SP payroll December 2020. So in this payroll, you select the name of the payroll. Different payrolls are there. If you remember, we had defined SP payroll. And so this is the biweekly payroll. This is the payroll period for which you are running this payroll. Let's say I'm running it for 25 or for 24. This is the process date. What is the run type? By default, you can leave this because process date, earn date, these are already defined in your payroll periods. Run type, regular or supplemental. Regular is your regular salary cycle. Supplemental is if you're paying additional like bonus or overtime or things like that. You can say supplemental also. Relationship group element. Relationship group is a small group of employees that you want to process. Element group is small group of employees that you want to process. If you don't select anything, every employee, every element will be processed. Now, this is a payroll process. This will run for 2-3 hours probably. So many employees will be there, nah? Unless it fails in between or it ends in an error. So when you are practicing your formula, what you can do, see, these are the employee records who are part of that payroll, not started. So individually, it will show you the status for individual employees.
This was big formula.
It says default for this basic salary. Let's look at this one only. Okay. So here what we are doing, we are looking at the basic salary, whatever is there in the assignment entry value for the salary amount. That an input is basic, is percentage. That means there will be an HRA element. HRA element will have an input value called percentage.
Now first to go to the default for age, the salary is a very block variable, right?
Huh. This is the default one.
No, this age is salary, first line.
Hmm.
The age is salary, is it a variable, right?
It's a database item.
Database item.
Uh-huh. So you have to search for the database item and pick that.
No, can you show me for the employee where is it a...
What?
Database item, sir. How do you see in front end this?
In that fast formula on the sidebar, we saw no? The fast formula.
I know.
You can search for the database item.
Database that I know in the is it displayable or what?
Yeah, you have forgotten everything, yaar, Sadiq.
No, I'm not asking in the element screen. They are not in formula screen. Age is salary. How do you see an employee in from future?
How do you see an employee?
For an employee.
For an employee, you can't see. This is the name of the database item. You have to use the database item. Once you run the formula, then through quick pay, you can see the result for that employee. If you want to see it for one employee, you have to run the quick pay and see it.
No, just for which the form of pass formula, which element it is attached? Can you show good?
You have to go to the element and check formula results.
No, for which element they attach this formula, because we write formula separate and we'll go attach to element.
So you will attach it to the, for example, you want to do HRA calculation. Okay. So you will attach that formula to the HRA element.
I know. But what you have shown, because I want to check later.
Hmm.
I want to know how to see which this formula attached to which element. I want to find that.
So you will define one element for this. Na? So you will attach it to that element.
This is already attached to some element, right? Now, my question is, I want to find, you have the formula, you got the formula. I want to know for which element this formula is attached.
You will not see for which element. You will see to one element which formula is attached. So you have to go first look at the element, and then from that element, you have to see which formula is attached.
So it is like from element and then formula.
Yeah. Let me show you that. Unless you get this flow clear in your head, na, everything will appear very confusing. Let's say regular. Because formulas are used for different purposes, so it's difficult to link it back to one. That is how their design is.
Yeah, I understand what is formula. I'm trying to, for example, if I want to debug something, how to proceed? That's what I'm.
So here, when you come to this status processing rule, na, for an element, here you will find the name of the element formula. You see this formula name?
Yeah.
So this is the name of the. Then you have to copy this. Then go to your formula and then you have to search for that particular formula. See, this is the formula. Okay, and here you have the database item. So you can search for your database items from here. So you can say like bonus. So these are all your database items. Okay. So like in that formula we had na assignment entry value. See, A is the entry value. So this is for the salary we are picking up, for the salary, basic salary entry value into percentage. So we suppose we are saying 50. So if you are passing 50% as the percentage, so it will do 50 into this divided by 100, and it will return HRA from the formula, through the formula.
Again, default is coming. So what it looks like a multiple calculation in the same.
Where?
No, actually, it's they are telling multiple values here.
These are all different input values, na? That's why.
This is the first time. I think I have to go through again. Just confused with this formula. Just open this.
Hey, come on, yeah. You are a developer. How can you get confused with this?
No, show me that.
Do you have multiple input? You have multiple variables, right? We default inputs. We pass default values. We pass for multiple variables. So these are all individual variables. Okay. So these are all used inside the formula later on. These are the ones that are created by Oracle are pretty exhaustive and quite confusing. Don't go by, you know, what Oracle has done. They use huge amount of,
this is the Oracle written formula, right?
Yeah. See at the top, copyright Oracle Corporation. So our stuff is usually very simple, straightforward kind of thing. You know, something like this, default for this. If you are using more than one element or input value, we'll have default for different input values, right? And inputs are, this is the percentage. And HRA is the percentage into this divided by 100. And we return HRA. Okay.
These guys create one create formula, two create element. What are all those things?
So which one?
Come down this same. One create formula, two create element. The same. Come down. Scroll down. What is this?
This is a practice. Create a formula, create the element, eligibility rule, add the formula to the input value. This is for what you have already done, no? This one, the one, this is the sample below. This one is for calculating employee provident fund and employer provident fund. Deduction is 12%. So formula will return two values. One is employee contribution, one is employer contribution.
No, this is your text?
Yeah. So this employee contribution will be direct. Employer contribution will be indirect to another element called employer provident fund. So what will be the formula? Formula will be SP basic salary amount, ASG entry value. This is the default. Inputs are percentage. Employee contribution is percentage into the salary, basic salary. Employer contribution is 8% always. So 8 into this much. and you can pass a message out. Message one is this, message two is this, and you can pass out this message one, message two from the system.
Okay.
Understood the flow?
Somehow, I think I need to work out.
So what you have to do, you have to first create an element.
Okay.
Let's say create two elements. Employee contribution, employee PF, and employer PF. Okay. Then create a formula. Link the formula to the element through the eligibility, through the status processing rules. Okay. Direct to the element and indirect to the other element, which is employer PF element. Okay. Direct to the employee PF element, indirect to the employer. Then next step after this, run quick pay and check. No. Next will be create element entry value, entry for an employee by giving employee provident fund, EF element entry. Okay. Followed. Next is run quick pay. Got it?
Yeah.
So this is how you should do it. So this is your sample followed.
I'll try. Yeah.
Yeah. Yeah. Try it out. Unless you try, you will not know. So today what we have covered, processing of payroll, quick pay and normal processing. What are the different steps? We said payroll, prepayment, archive, generate the payslip, check payment or bank transfer file. Then you generate the payslip. Then you do the costing process. Then you transfer to GL. That is the whole flow.
But the costing we didn't see, and the element balances are still I'm not clear.
Okay. Now, two things. Let me just show you. Since you're not clear about it.